Hello everyone, we have a legend from Bay Area who is a doctor by heart, who produced Doctor by Heart and who won a great award in Delhi International Film Festival for the concept. Dr. Romesh Japra, right here with us at Chandni Restaurant in New York. It's an honor and a pleasure to have you here, sir. Welcome to Your India TV with me, Jasleen Khanuja. And tell us a little more about Doctor by Heart and the award that you have recently received.
Absolutely, Jasleen. First of all, congratulations to you for this.
Your India.
Okay, Your India TV, wonderful. That's a beautiful name and sounds very good. And of course, you know, we go a long way back. You've been a great activist in the community here. And, you know, this award, this Doctor by Heart is not just for me. It's for the whole community. I've been here for last more than 40 years. And what we've been able to accomplish, achieve, and how we've been able to connect the community, inspire the community, empower the community, and that's what it is all about. It's not about me. How I got the opportunity to do this for the community out there. When I came, there was very few of us, and there was no IT, there was no this big technology. But we've been fortunate enough to develop this right here in the United States of America, bring up the Indian American community to the point where now we are so confident, we are so good in every sphere of whether it's a science, whether it's medicine, whether it's technology, whether it's just small businesses. I think our people are excelling, they're enjoying it, they're celebrating it, they're contributing it towards the prosperity of this United States of America.
Absolutely, and many of you won't know that he is the man who started the Fremont Hindu Temple about a decade back. So he is the founder.
It's 83.
Oh my God, I'm massively underestimating.
It's 35 years.
That's phenomenal. That's my bad.
That's all right. 35 years ago, believe me, there was a Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. There was all these Yankees and all these other people who were going to India. So it was very tough to get a permit. And we had to buy a church and convert it into a temple those days. We would not be allowed because they thought we are here to convert people into Hindus and Sikhs and all the stuff. And believe me, after that temple, we had Gurdwara, we had Masjid, we had everything. And I don't want to take that credit, but fortunately, we were right in that position that the mayor was my patient. He was a heart patient. I'm being a cardiologist. I had a little bit leeway. He tried his best. He could not get us a permit. Then he said, okay, there's a Seventh-day Adventist church, so why don't you buy this and I'll buy them a bigger church. And that's how we will be able to buy this first temple in California, started that way.
And you put your own 10K
at that time.
In 83, it must be a really big sum.
Fortunately, it was only doctors who had a little money. I mean, there was, like I said, you know, all these even IIT people, they used to run either 7-Elevens or gas stations or have some real estate. And that's the only way they could make extra money. Otherwise, the salary was not enough. But we used to have our own practices, so we could make a little extra money. I was able to put that and raise about $80,000 and buy this church to convert it into a temple.
Phenomenal, and each one of you goes there, bows there, and especially I see on Karwa Chauth, I mean, the ladies beautifully dressed up, and they are celebrating like they celebrate in India, so that's really wonderful. And you have also come up with Festival of Globe, you know, you had the organization FIA,
sure.
Federation of Indo-Americans, and then you renamed it, I believe, to Festival of Globe. So tell us the background, the story.
Absolutely, you know, I mean, after we had the temple, even this temple, we called it Fremont Hindu Temple and Cultural Center. You know, we have these children who didn't want to be called Indians. They said, okay, you know, we're born here, we are Americans, they don't want to wear Indian clothes, Indian foods, Indian dresses. And so it was very difficult, even though they were being discriminated, they go to the school, they said, hey, get Indians, you get out of here. This is the kind of stuff we went through, but fortunately, we were able to bring them up and show our culture, our philosophies, our values, our traditions. And it came to the point when they were confused Desis, ABCD, American Born Confident Desis. Now they are still ABCD, but now they are American Born Confident Desis.
Absolutely.
And it's come a long way. To cut it short, of course, we had the Federation of Indo-Americans, which we founded. And then I started this festival, parade, called it Festival of India in 93, right from when Asha Bara came. Then we had Devanand, we had Bijanti Mala, we've had Amitabh Bachchan, Dharmender and Shatrughan Sinha. I mean, now the recently we have people like Manoj Bajpayee, and so all these kind of people have come, and then from 5,000 we have made it up to 150,000 people come and join
That's
a parade
fantastic.
and the Mela. So it's come a long way. So we've been taken along everybody else, and of course this IT in 1999 Y2K took over, and Indian IT went up, and now we are the number one in the world to really come up with the innovations. No matter what, it was just the internet, it was the IoT, now the AI, it's a blockchain. I think we are really innovating all these things and helping the whole world put this thing together. And in the Silicon Valley right here, I think we're very, very fortunate when we can have a temple, we have a gurdwara, we have a masjid, and even Indian churches. You know, we had people from Keralites, I know, P.T. Memon and Papa Chan, you know, they worked with me, and we all worked together. We don't have any problem with the religions over here, but we want to make sure that Indian Americans get empowered, inspired, and they can be really number one citizens.
Wonderful. And you have laid the foundation stone, and you're also helping them build it and grow it into a big, big monument. So that's really phenomenal. But as a doctor, you know, I want to ask you a general question. You know, I see a lot of people from Indian community who suffer from blood pressure and diabetes. You know, these are the two most common problems. Almost all the people who are 60 plus suffer from this kind of a problem. Not all Americans, but people from Indian origin. So why?
Well, unfortunately, we have, like you said, three times more risk than the Caucasians, being an Indian Americans or the South Asian Americans, as we call them. And the reason has been, there is something called metabolic syndrome. We are born with insulin resistance. We are born with the high triglycerides, low HDL, which is the good cholesterol. And of course, you know, and then we have the waist is a little bit bigger than everybody else out there. So this all constitutes like a metabolic syndrome, these three things: high triglycerides, low HDL, and the insulin resistance. So we are more prone to diabetes, more prone to hypertension, more prone to have heart disease over there. So that's why we have to work extra. You know, as an immigrant, I had to work extra. Three times, you know, I've been chief of medicine, cardiology, chief of staff in my hospital. I've been through a lot of discrimination, but we have come through. Same thing, the IT people, I remember, you know, nobody thought they could ever become CEOs of the company, but now the company will not start in Silicon Valley until they have one or two Indians on board. So that's what I'm proud of. Similarly, on these diseases, we have to work three times extra to take care of ourselves, because some of this is hereditary, some of them is lifestyle, especially the first time the immigrants. They are over-ambitious, they work extra, they get a lot of stress, a lot of strain. So the three things I tell people to avoid these things is watch your diet, exercise regularly, and take less stress. If you follow these three things, you can take over the hereditary part and you can be the winner.
How do you take less stress though?
The less stress is, the stress is always there, but this is how you take it. Through our meditation, through yoga, and many of the other things, if you want to help people, you're going to be healthy. So if you take your stress on yourself, you cannot help others. The idea is, the less you take on yourself, be strong, be resilient, and be positive all the time, I think the stress will walk away. It'll run away from you, and you'll be able to help a lot more people and help yourself, your friends, your family, and everybody else around in your community.
Wonderful. Those were great health tips as well. Thank you so much, Dr. Japra, for supporting the community in all the ways. Any message for Yo India TV viewers?
First of all, thank you very much and congratulations. Keep up the good work, and please come and join us at the Festival of Globe 2018. It's going to be on the 18th and 19th of August, Saturday and Sunday, and then of course a week before we do the film festival. It's like a global film festival. We're going to do the FoG summit, and of course a lot of other activities. Save the date, join us. So let's empower together, not only just the Indian Americans, but the Indians worldwide.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.